Hello, today I've got for you a really unusual device. It is portable digital to analog converter with headphone amplifier made by company Cozoy, model named Rei. It surprised me really a lot because I didn't expect such a good sound quality from such a small device. It is pretty highly priced. It cost about $550. It sold about this price. It depends on country, taxes and so on, but actually it is expensive, but sound quality really worth it. But let's see it in more details. As you can see, box is fairly simple. It is white cardboard. On the back side there are highlighted some features. It supports up to DSD256, 384 kHz, 32 ohms low, support Lightning and USB, DSD over PCM, plug and play, and so on and so forth. It's not really powerful, while 1 volt RMS for 32 ohms load, so it's decided for the mainly for IEMs, but it's really good with IEMs. Actually, here is a recommended special player for this digital tonal converter, but that I've used my Mac to listen to this digital tonal converter. So inside we'll have small envelope with manual and advertisement, set of cables, USB to USB, micro USB to micro USB, Lightning to micro USB, and regular USB to micro USB, so you can connect it to your iPhone, Android or PC. The only cable that is missing is USB-C probably. And here is Rei himself or itself. When I looked to its photos, I've expected that it will be bigger, but it's really tiny and small. As you can see, it's made of aluminium, only 6 millimeters in width. It has interesting, unusual shape, and it's pretty simple. Here is micro USB in that you can use to connect to the source, and headphone output. And this button is used to play and pause playback. So it's really simple device. You connect it to your source and you connect your headphones and you will have it. There is no battery inside, so it's powered from USB port. There is no some LEDs, no indicators, no volume regulation, nothing. It's pretty thin, so you can easily use it with your smartphone with ease. It won't require a lot of space in your pocket. So it is really portable device. And about the sound. So as I've said before, it's not very powerful device. It provides just 1 volt RMS for 32 ohms load. From one point of view, it's not too much for some power hungry headphones. From other point of view, it's more than enough for 90% of IEMs, and it's enough for some more sensitive full size headphones. Actually, with IEMs, it sounds superbly. It doesn't have any background noise, it doesn't have any traces of hiss, it provides good control and good control all over the all frequencies and good resolution. So bass is deep, it's punchy, it's tight, it's very well controlled. There is no traces of lacking power if headphones actually normal for this digital tonal converter. Bass is really good texture, it's very good in layer separation, it's very good in texturing, and thanks to this absolutely black background, all notes appear on this black background with crisp and detailed sounds. Mids are emotional, they are not too dry, they really good in portraying emotions and really good in representing vocals. It has some hint of silky smoothness on the vocals and it sounds really superb. imaginary stage is really good. It's deep and it's spacious. It's deep and it's wide and with good layer separation and depth and with good instrument separation. So it's almost perfect. And actually, treble is also nice with good attacks, decays. It's not treble shy device. You will hear all the treble that is present in the recording. So if you are treble phobic, you probably should look for something more hiding treble. But for those who are okay with high frequencies, it provides really good, airy, crisp sound with perfect attacks, with perfect decays and good representation. I don't know actually what magic is put inside of this small device. I don't know what chip is used inside, but it's really sound very, very nicely. I think it really worth that money. Even having some more powerful desktop devices for IEMs, I prefer Rei most of times. It's a bit picky for the source, so I'm using my MacBook Pro with Audirvana Plus, and it gives really good results. I tried it with my iPhone, actually also giving really nice results, but I think it's expensive, but it really worth this money. Thank you for attention.